Today we are going to start this chapter manufacturing, and in this chapter in this module mainly we are going to discuss about the definition, importance and industrial location. So let us see one by one. So if we think about the definition, so what is manufacturing? The definition is production of goods in large quantities after processing from raw material to more valuable product is called manufacturing. This definition is given in your book very clearly. Example of manufacturing can be here. The paper is manufactured from wood. Sugar from sugarcane, iron and steel from iron ore, aluminium from bauxite. So do you know that some type of clothes are manufactured from yarn, which itself is an industrial product? This yarn you can say as intermediate goods also, as it is already an industrial produce. And it is used for production in further process. The economic strength of a country is measured by development of manufacturing industries. Of course, whenever we think about development of any country, immediately we start thinking about the industrial development of the country. Nowadays, as we know that China is the fastest growing economy, and that Chinese economy is growing with a very fast rate only because of industrial development. Manufacturing sector of that China has developed many times than India's development. Importance of manufacturing. So manufacturing sector is considered the backbone of development in general and economic development in particular mainly because manufacturing industries not only help in modernizing agriculture, which forms the backbone of our economy, they also reduce the heavy dependence of people on agricultural income by providing them job in secondary and tertiary sector. As because of manufacturing, the people are getting employment opportunities and the burden from the agriculture is reducing because of this manufacturing. Industrial development is precondition for eradication of unemployment and poverty from our country. Of course, if we want to remove the poverty, unemployment, we need industrialization, because one industry starts, number of other side activities starts along with it. So this was the main philosophy behind public sector industries and joint sector venture in India after the independence, just after the first 5-year plan, around 1960s you can say, just end of the 1960s. It was also aimed at bringing down the regional disparities. Disparity here means the differences, by establishing industries in tribal and backward areas. Government tries to establish and motivate the people to establish industries in those areas which are backward areas, so that the development of that backward areas can be lifted up. Export of manufactured goods depend on trade and commerce and bring in much needed foreign exchange. So this is also very important part of economy. When export of manufactured good is there, then foreign exchange come, which is needed for many other essential goods required in our country. Countries that transform their raw material into a wide variety of finished goods of higher value are prosperous. This sentence see very clearly that countries that transform their raw material means mainly that natural products, natural goods, natural resources into a wide variety of finished goods of higher value, the countries are prosperous. Because if we sell the natural resources, the natural goods that are of cheaper rate in comparison to the finished goods, that is why the countries which are better in finished goods part, so they are prosperous. India's prosperity lies in increasing and diversifying its manufacturing industries as quickly as possible. Need of the hour. So in the present day of world of globalization, our industry needs to be more efficient and competitive. As we know that this is the day of globalization. All the countries' economies are open to sell and buy goods from any of the country. The producer of the country are free to buy goods from any country. So that way, there is no pressure on the buyer, they will buy from which country. So that way, the competition is much higher in the world. And if we are trying to exist in the economy of the world, we have to be efficient and competitive. Our qualities of goods should be efficient, should be very high, so that can create good demand in the market. Self-sufficiency alone is not enough. It is not just enough that we are self-reliant in different goods production. So that is why we need to be efficient and competitive. We should have that quality of goods which can get demand in the all over the world countries. Our manufactured goods must be at par. At par means able to compete in quality with those in the world or international market. Means whatever goods are produced in our country, that should have the quality which can compete with the qualities of other countries' goods. Only then we will be able to compete in the international market. So this is the need of the hour. If we want to develop in the world economy, if we want that different goods and services which are of best quality available in the world, we should have. So for that, we have to expand our export also. Otherwise, we will not have that foreign currency which is required to import the goods from other countries which are not available in our country. So we need to be efficient and competitive. Contribution of industry to national economy. Over the last two decades, the share of manufacturing sector has stagnated. Stagnated means remained at the same. Stagnated 17% of GDP out of the total 27% of the industry, which include 10% of mining, quarrying, electricity and gas. This is much lower in comparison to some East Asian economies where it is 25 to 35%. The trend of growth rate in manufacturing over the last decade has been around 7% per annum. The desired growth rate over the next decade is 12%. Since 2003, manufacturing is once again growing at the rate of 9 to 10% per annum. So this is a brief of contribution of industry to the national economy. Industrial location. Whenever we are or any industrialist is going to set up industry, that industrialist is influenced by some physical factor, economic factor, or you can say human factors. So industrial locations are influenced by availability of raw material, of course. The availability of raw material is, this raw material is the main source of production, or you can say the main inputs of production. So first of all, the industrialists think about the raw material. Easy and cheap rate availability of raw material. Then second, the major contribution on the production is this labor. So labor, the cheap rate and skilled labor is desired by the industrialists. So industrialists think about where and what kind of labor will be easily available. So it is thought by the industrialists. Then capital requirement, that money from where the industrialist can get easy loan facilities, the money required, the building required. Then power. As we know that most of the machines run by the electricity or any other kind of fuel, petroleum or natural gas. So that availability, easy availability of power supply and good availability of power supply is required. Then market, because easy accessibility to the market is very much helpful for the industry for minimizing the cost of production. So that way producer think about the market also. It is rarely possible to find all these factors available at one place. Of course, this is not very easy to get all these at one place in best available form. So consequently, manufacturing activities tend to locate at the most appropriate place where all these factors of industrial location are either available or can be arranged at lower cost. So producer think what can be the best location where the producer can lower the cost, minimize the cost of production. After an industrial activity starts, urbanization follows. We know that once an industry is set up at a place, afterward an urbanization starts and all other facilities slowly increase in that area, and that way it is very good for the development of any country. So when the industries are locating at a place, so there is one advantage, economies. Here economies meaning is the saving, a kind of saving. That saving is in the form of reduction in the cost of production. So agglomeration economies are obtained by the industrialist. How? Let us see. Sometimes industries are located in or near the cities. Thus industrialization and urbanization go hand in hand. So industrialization, industries are set up, and urbanization means the people are residing in nearby that industry. Number of facilities provider also set up their service providing units, and slowly that area is converted in urban area. So that way cities provide market and also provide services such as banking, insurance, transport, labor, consultants, that legal advisors or engineers, whatever, financial advice, etc. to the industry. So many industries tend to come together to make use of advantages offered by the urban centers known as agglomeration economies. So that economy is agglomeration. Agglomeration means collecting at a place, pool, collection. So agglomeration economy means due to agglomerating in the city's areas, an economy is obtained by the producers. That only known as agglomeration economy. Gradually, a large industrial agglomeration takes place. Thank you, students. Revise these topics in your book, which we have discussed in this module, and write the definitions. Thank you. Have a nice day.